So now let's talk about bone formation. The process of bone formation is referred to as ossification or osteogenesis. There are four situations where bone formation will occur. First, during embryological or fetal development. Second, when you are growing or as your bones grow before adulthood. Third, all throughout your life as your bones remodel. And finally, in a situation where you have to heal a fracture. So there are two forms of bone formation or ossification. There's intramembranous ossification, and then there's endochondral ossification. Intramembranous ossification is usually associated with the formation of the flat bones, like those in the skull, whereas endochondral ossification is usually associated with the formation of the other bones in the body, and specifically the long bones in the body. So when it comes to intramembranous ossification, or the formation of flat bones, there are four major steps. In the first step, the mesenchymal cells in the mesenchyme of the fetus are going to create an ossification center. These cells will then differentiate into osteoblast cells. These osteoblast cells then secrete extracellular matrix, including collagen fibers. In the second step, as the osteoblasts are surrounded by the extracellular matrix that they secrete, they then differentiate into mature osteocyte cells. These osteocytes are now housed inside of little areas called lacunae. From there, bone matrix begins to calcify. The third step is now the formation of the outer portion of the bone, or the periphery of the bone. First, the mesenchyme is going to form a periosteum, and the mesenchymal cells are now going to be replaced with osteoblast cells. As well, in this step, we start to form the trabeculae, which are the little projections that are found in spongy bone. Also, blood vessels start to infiltrate through the holes that are found throughout the trabeculae. In the final step of intramembranous ossification, compact bone is starting to be formed toward the periphery of the bone. The periosteum starts to form the fibrous periosteum layer on the outside of the bone. And inside of the bone, the spongy bone begins to be filled with red marrow as the red blood cells are starting to form marrow tissue.